I've been telling you guys that it's my responsibility to change the narratives of Africa. And also, it's my responsibility to let Africans know that Africa belongs to them. Do you think that Africans should grab Africa like the way they grab their woman?
Of course! Of course! Africans should grab Africa the way they grab their woman.
You know, your story is really inspiring.
Thank you.
And I think all Kenyans know you to be what?
Alex Mwakideu.
What do you do?
Radio personality.
And how long have you been on radio?
16 years.
16 years?
16 years.
Incredible.
I'm telling you.
Were you born in Nairobi?
No, I was not born in Nairobi. I was born in Mombasa.
Born and raised in Mombasa?
Yes.
And what happened to you? You left Kenya already or you lived all your life in Kenya?
No. I've been to different places. Mm-hmm. Worked in Deutsche Welle in Germany.
Oh, okay.
For some time. There's a team also from the UK. We used to do international reporting for sporting events like the Olympics in Beijing, which I covered, for radio stations around East Africa that broadcast in Swahili. So I also went to Melbourne to broadcast also Commonwealth Games for radio stations around East Africa that broadcast in Swahili, because I'm a Swahili broadcaster.
A really international Swahili broadcaster.
But, Swahili international, yeah.
How long did you live in Germany?
6 months only. 6 months only and I was done.
Are you crazy?
They offered me an opportunity to stay some more, but I said, let me go back to Kenya.
You left Germany after 6 months to come back to Kenya?
Yes.
Why?
Why? Because I think Kenya is beautiful. You know, because of the people, because it's my home, you know. And there's so many opportunities in Kenya for you to grab and move on and make more money in Kenya than I used to make in Germany.
You mean you make more money in Kenya than in Germany?
Definitely. It is like almost 500% more than what I used to make in Germany. So much more, I can't even think twice about it. If you call me today and tell me go to Germany and work in Deutsche Welle, I'll tell you no. Straight on. Hell no.
What took you to radio?
Radio was like a miracle, I think. I would say that because I was an actor. I used to act in school, then I used to act professionally around Nairobi, Mombasa. I've been acting to so many stages, doing solo verses, plays and stuff. So we used to have a group called Horo Horo Thespians in Mombasa. So there was this time when a client wanted a radio script that would be like radio drama. So I came in with my few of my colleagues from the industry, and we did a script like 30 minutes only. Written the script, voiced the script, and it was so nice.
Okay.
The client said, these are the guys. These are the guys. This is exactly what I wanted. So I want them to continue doing my scripts throughout. So that's how I just got into radio, into doing scripts, commercial scripts. And there was this one news editor, Peter Musembi. He's now in BBC London.
Okay.
He was our news editor at Baraka FM in Mombasa. He told me, hey, you have a voice for radio and you can actually read news. I was like, oh, really? Yeah. So he told me to start practicing pole pole. And I started practicing, listening to other media houses, BBC, Swahili broadcasting media houses. You know, I started practicing. And this one time, the president came to Mombasa to open Mombasa Showground. So there was a lot of traffic. Our news anchor was actually reporting the story. And I was alone in the studio. Musembi told me, hey, this is your chance. This is your chance.
Whoa.
It's a do or die. You're going live on radio to broadcast the 1 p.m. news bulletin. I was like, really? Are you for sure? And he gave me the scripts. He told me, okay, you go through the scripts because this guy cannot make it. He won't be here by 1. We must have a bulletin at 1 p.m. So I said, okay, fine. And I went on air and I did my thing. Coming out of the studio, it was so nice, by the way. Though, of course, I panicked here and there, but it was so nice. When I came out of the studio, all of them were listening to radio. It was so loud and they were clapping and they told me, you've done so well. You should be our news anchor. You're reading the news at 2 p.m. and 3 p.m. and 4 p.m. and the rest of the afternoon.
And that's why you said being a radio presenter is a miracle.
It's a miracle. It's a miracle. It's a miracle to me, yeah.
I'm so glad that you left Germany after 6 months. You came back here to discover what you actually want to do on the continent. Brother, like, I'm not going to say you've made it, but I mean, you are getting there.
Yeah.
Because there's so many Africans that tell me that, we cannot make it in Africa. We have to go abroad, get money before we come back. But you are making everything in here. What did you do to support the whole radio business?
What did I do to support it?
Yeah.
I went out there to learn. You know, we took a plus international now. The guys in the UK, mm-hmm. I learned a lot from them. While in Germany, I learned a lot about our feature stories, about broadcasting interviews and stuff. And so when I came back with so much content, which really helped me, even helping other people who are growing up in Mombasa, in the industry, Baraka FM. Then when I came to Nairobi, of course, all that knowledge, because I came to Nairobi to start up a new station, that is Radio Maisha. Yeah.
Your own station.
Not mine. No. I'm not there yet. But go willing, I should be there.
Very soon.
Yeah, very soon. Ooh, I should be there.
Okay.
So when we came back, we were called because these media houses, the Standard Media Group, wanted people who are good, who can come up and start their station, their first radio station, because it was a newspaper and TV only. All right. So they wanted radio. They're like 100 years now, one of the oldest media houses in Kenya. So we came in, and because of knowledge, we really helped bring up that radio station. Right now, by the time I was leaving that radio station, it was at number one.
Whoa.
In the whole country. It was at number one.
Impressive.
That was in 2018.
2018?
Yes, it was at number one. Then I joined Milele FM. Yeah? Joined Milele FM, because mine is to really, you know, go to other radio stations and, you know, help impact everywhere, you know. Meet other people, we exchange ideas and, you know, become better radio presenters.
You know where we are? We are at a car wash.
Yeah.
Pampered Ride Car Wash.
Yeah.
Is that one, is it for you or are you working with someone?
It's mine. It's mine, yeah.
Why? You're not interested in the radio?
I'm still interested in the radio.
What happened?
I'm actually doing radio, I think, for the rest of my life.
Oh, okay.
Radio is a lifestyle to me.
For you, okay.
It's a lifestyle. I will do it until I get very old. Yeah, so this one came up because I love cars so much. I love doing things I love, in Africa, in Kenya. And I like telling people, do the things you like to do, you know, because this is your land, this is your place, this is your area. You can explore, you can do whatever you want to do because you're at home. Yeah, so create opportunities for yourselves. So me, I love cars so much. So I started importing cars from Japan to Kenya to sell online.
Okay.
And actually, it was like a miracle again. You know, because I'm here, I'm importing cars and I'm getting clients. Because I didn't want to sell them, you know, at a very high price. No, I wanted to sell, just get something small. Yeah, so I got a lot of clients. I sold like almost 8 cars very fast. I was like, oh, wow. Then later on, because I have a friend of mine who has a Shining Sparkle, that is a car wash. I used to wash my car there. And he's a very good friend of mine. He's called Steve Nyabwa. So Steve told me, you can start yours too. So Steve took me through almost every, you know, and this is what we are supposed to do as Africans, as Kenyans, you know. When somebody wants to start something, you hold their hands, you take them to that place. So Steve actually worked with me until the first Pampered Rice car wash came up, which is not this one, actually. This is only 2 months. This one that I started in April. It's in Athi River. So until it came up, and I was so happy about it, and even the monies I used to, I'm getting there. So when this opportunity came up, I said, why not? Let me start another one. So this is only 2 months.
So this is only 2 months?
2 months,
you have two of these car wash.
Two of these car wash. That's why this year.
Is it worth it to invest in car wash?
It is. It is, definitely.
I want you to say something I know nobody has ever asked you.
Yeah.
Are you sure, like, okay, don't tell anybody. Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you think that you're making more than being a radio presenter?
Here?
Yeah.
WODEMAYA! WODEMAYA!
You know, like...
All right.
There's this ideology about Africans knowing that, hey, I went to school, I want to be a doctor, an engineer.
Yeah.
I want to look for a white-collar job.
Yeah.
Something that is respectable.
Yeah.
But...
I will tell you something, okay?
Thank you.
As a radio presenter right now, I'm being paid a lot of money.
Yeah.
A lot of money as a radio presenter, because I also bring a lot of money.
Okay.
You know, for the show.
Yeah.
Yeah. So they have to pay me.
Exactly.
Good money, okay?
Good money, yeah.
Good money, and it's not a joke. So at the moment, I'm only 2 months here.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm almost heading there. This, by the time I'm in June next year, it will double what I earn as a radio presenter. This one alone.
So tell us.
Projections.
Are there opportunities in Africa for Africans?
Of course, a lot of them.
So why are we not seeing them?
There are a lot of them. I'm doing this, but this is not just purely car wash. Because guys in Kitengela, the entire Kitengela, every person is just washing cars. But I'm saying, right here, I'm doing buffing, I'm doing interior wash, I'm doing steam engine cleaning, I'm doing rim cleaning, I'm doing headlight restoration, because there's nobody else doing that. So you have to look at the car and say, okay, what do I want to do? Do I want to put music system? Do I want to tint the cars? Do I want to, you know, so that you don't, we don't wash cars, all of us. That's the only problem. But the opportunities are many, many in Kenya.
We have so many young Africans watching us right now.
Yeah.
If you should advise young Africans watching us, what are you going to say?
Number one, what do you like? What do you like? Because you have to, there must be something that drives you. What do you love? What is your passion? That which is your passion, try so much and make money from that which you like. This guy here, WODEMAYA, is making money.
He's making money.
Doing and traveling all over the country, all over Africa.
Exactly.
He's traveling all over Africa,
exactly.
Making money, shooting videos and being happy, you know?
That's all.
And that is a good vibe.
Exactly.
And that is what we're talking about. What do you like? I love cars. That's why I'm doing this. And I love radio. That's why I'm doing radio.
I'm inspired, man.
Thanks, bro.
Really
Thanks,
inspired.
Bro.
I want to say
bro.
Thank you so much for talking to me. But one more thing.
Yeah.
We got Africans who are always going to want to cross the borders.
Yeah.
I mean, want to leave the shores of Africa.
Yeah.
Some of them even use the bad way to get to wherever they want to go
yeah.
to. If you should talk to such Africans,
yeah.
what will you say?
There is what you want out there, and there is what we have in here. Okay? So the only thing we need is to make it in life. All of us want to make it in life. And you can make it in life here. I was in Germany for 6 months. They offered me 2 more years contract and then another 3 years after that one. I said, no, I want to come back home. Why? Because it's money at home. And I've done well, actually, as a radio presenter. And I'm also trying this business, which is doing pretty well. Mm. And I've seen so many other Africans here in Kenya who are doing pretty well. And they will never go anywhere. So this is where you are. This is your home. Our motherland has everything you need. It is up to you to reach out and say, okay, let me go this direction or that direction. And then let's make Africa beautiful.
I want to say thank you so much for talking to me.
Karibu, bro.
You, man.